الحمد لله وكفى بالله شهيدا وكفى بالله وكيلا والصلاة والسلام على خير المرسلين خاتم النبيين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي اللهم اجعلنا دعاة إليك وإلى رسولك أما بعد فقد قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا أقل كالتدبير صدق الله العلي العظيم وصدق رسول الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين ومن الشاكرين Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Indeed, all praises are for Allah, Rabbul Alameen. Allah, the Lord of the worlds, Maliki Yawmiddin. Allah, who is the master. Allah, who is the king. Allah, who is the owner of Yawmuddin, the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that one. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. It is only Allah we worship. It is only Allah's aid we seek. We send peace and blessings on Allah's final messenger, Khatam al-Nabiyyin, the seal of the prophets, Rahmatul al-Alameen, mercy to the entire world. Subhanallah, Al-Adlul Amin, the most just, the most truthful, the most trustworthy, Muhammad Mustafa, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Indeed, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, we have often heard of the saying, if you fail to prepare, then prepare to fail. Many times we would have heard it. Have we ever sat down and pondered upon these words? If you fail to prepare, then prepare to fail. Every time we face some imtihan and some examinations in life, whether it be at the primary school level, the secondary school level, whether it be the college level, whether it be the university level, imtihan, examination, tests, our teachers always say to us, if you fail to prepare, then prepare to fail. What is the difference? What is the difference when it comes to the month of Ramadan? What is the difference when it comes to this sacred, this blessed month, which is known as Ramadan, full of blessings, where the rewards of the believer are increased? Everything that we will do in Ramadan, the recitation of Quran, the giving of sadaqah and charity, any virtuous deed, any act of ibadah, the fasting in Ramadan, the salah in Ramadan, the smiling in Ramadan, the brotherhood in Ramadan, the sisterhood in Ramadan, every good action that the believer will do in the month of Ramadan, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us that there is an increase for those actions. If we did not prepare for Ramadan, If we did not prepare and we failed to prepare for the month of Ramadan, then we have no other reason. We have nothing else to blame, nobody else to blame, but only ourselves, that we will be prepared to fail in Ramadan. That Ramadan will come and we will not get what is in that month. The rewards in that month, the blessings in that month, the forgiveness in that month, the drawing closer to Allah in that month, the opening of the gates of paradise in that month, the closing of the doors of Jahannam in that month. If we did not prepare for this month, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, sadly to say, we're all going to be failures. This is why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, educated us, practical examples in his life. We don't have to go to any books to read. The life of the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam is enough as a guide. Many of us would have heard before that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in this month which is known as Shaban, he would fast and fast and fast as though he would not stop fasting in this month. Why? Preparation for Ramadan. He will give and he will give and he will give in this month of in Shaban. Preparation for the month of Ramadan. Because when the month of Ramadan would appear and dawn upon him, subhanAllah, the hadith says that there will be no extent in his giving. He will give. He will fast. He will stand in salah. So in preparation for this month of Ramadan, today inshallah, I would like to highlight a few points that can help us in our preparation for this month of Ramadan. And the first thing that stands out in preparation for Ramadan, when we look at the blessed life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala an, he states that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would fast most regularly on Mondays and Thursdays throughout his life. Throughout his life, Mondays and Thursdays. Some companion asked him, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, why is it that you fast on Mondays and Thursdays? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, these are the days in which the deeds are taken to Allah for accountability. I like that my deeds are taken when I am in the state of siyam, when I am in the state of fasting. Because when a person is in the state of fasting, it's a different mindset, a different frame of mind. His heart is attached to Allah. Bad thoughts are, subhanAllah, emptied from the hearts and the mind. The recitation of the Quran, it comes. The dhikr of Allah, it comes. The giving, it comes. Every good thing when a person is fasting. So he says, I like that my deeds be presented at a time when I am fasting. The hadith goes on to say that every person on this day, every believer and every slave of Allah who did not associate any partners with Allah, Allah gives them forgiveness on this day. Allah grants them forgiveness on this day, excepting for those two people who had grudge in their hearts for each other, malice in their hearts for each other, envy in their hearts for each other. They had disputes and they stayed away from settling their disputes. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, until they can make up and patch up their differences, it is only then Allah is going to reckon their deeds. Allah is going to take their deeds, multiply their deeds. The hadith also comes in the hadith Qudsi, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, تُفْتَحُ الْأَبْوَابَ الْجَنَّةِ يَوْمُ الْإِثْنَيْنِ وَيَوْمُ الْقَمِيثِ. The doors of paradise are opened on the day of Monday and on Thursdays. The doors of paradise, they are opened on Mondays and Thursdays. Many hadiths comes to joys that the believer will meet with. The best times in the life of the believer, the two most delightful moments, the two most joyous times in the life of a believer is one, when he breaks the fast, and two, when he stands before Allah on the day of Qiyamah. Why is that moment a joyful moment? When many hearts will be trembling, many feet will be trembling, many souls will be shaken. But this believer, it's a joyful day for him that he is standing before Allah. It is because he would have prepared for the standing of that day. And this is what fasting does. This is what the fasting does. So the first thing is that we should try to engage ourselves as much as possible in fasting, at least Mondays and Thursdays, as a means of preparation for the month of Ramadan, so that when Ramadan comes, now we will be geared up, we will be ready, and subhanAllah, the fasting will become easy for us, because why? We would have been accustomed to it during the month of Sha'ban. But many times, we wait for when we see the hilal. And now we see the masajid being filled for the first night of Taraweeh. And the next morning is when we will wake up to fast. And because we were so accustomed not waking up for Fajr, subhanAllah, we sleep through the time for Sahri. We sleep through the time for Tahajjud. We sleep through everything, but the next day we get up and fast just like that. Because fasting is compulsory. Fasting is compulsory. So the doors of Jannat on Mondays and Thursdays, they are made to be opened. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَيُغْفَرُ لِكُلِّ عَبْدٍ لَا يُشْرِكُ بِاللَّهِ شَيْئًا. The servant who did not commit any shirk with Allah, who did not associate any partners with Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that servant of mine has been forgiven. He has been forgiven. Illa rajulan kanat bainahu wa baina akhihi shahna. Except for that man who between himself and his brother was some sort of grudge, some sort of malice, some sort of dispute. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, fayuqal, it will be said to them, anziru hadaini hatta yastaliha. Anziru hadaini hatta yastaliha. Anziru hadaini hatta yastaliha. Leave these two, delay these two until they are reconciled. Three times it is mentioned in the hadith. Leave these two until they can sort out their differences. Leave these two until they can come back together. Leave these two until they can be reconciled. Leave them. Nothing is taken from them in regards to their amal. These are the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He for Himself ordained fasting for us in the Quran. Kutiba alaykum as-siyam. But this is for the month of Ramadan. But the preparation is very, very important. Every single thing in life. Before we get married, there is some sort of preparation. We are talking about the nikah ceremony or the marriage ceremony. We're talking about in finding the right spouse. There is preparation for that. At the time of giving birth to a child, there is preparation for that. Subhanallah, at the time of this child going to kindergarten, preparation every single day in whatever aspect of life, whether it be business, whether it be social, whether it be physical, whether it be spiritual, every single walk of life, preparation, preparation, preparation. Why is it fasting anything less? Why is the month of Ramadan treated as though, you know, well, we'll be ready. We need to prepare. So the first thing is fasting on Mondays and Thursdays. That is the first thing. A second thing of preparation. The book of Allah, which we have on our shelves. The book of Allah, which after the last 10 nights in Ramadan, the moment we saw the hilal, that book was made to be resting on the shelves. It has gathered some dust. It's about time we wipe out the dust. It's about time we turn the pages. It's about time we open up that book, the Holy Quran. It is a zulum. It is an oppression to Allah's words. It is an oppression to Allah's book that we take Allah's book only on convenient times. That we take this book and open it up only on occasions. That is an oppression to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is as though we are using the book of Allah. Using the book of Allah. Which one of us likes to feel like that? Only on occasions. Only on occasions. We like to be seen. We like people to show us up. No, we want to be seen every day. We want to be helpful every day. We want to be involved in everything. We want to do everything. How would we feel occasionally if the husband says to the wife, you know, you cook good today, a very nice meal. Or the wife says to the husband, thanks for buying me a nice pair of shoes. Every single week she's getting a nice pair of shoes. But one time, yeah, thanks, eh? Every single day he's getting a nice meal. But one time, yeah, the meal was good. And not even your whole heart into it. What kind of feeling is that? The book of Allah, we need to attach ourselves to the Quran. Because why? شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ Because the month of Ramadan is such a month in which the Quran was revealed. And if we are waiting to go into the month of Ramadan, then to open the Quran, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, we will become so kaslan, so lazy, that even to open the book of Allah, we will find problems to do that. We will find problems. We will find it difficult. Because you see this thing they call procrastination? Tomorrow I'll do it. Tomorrow I'll do it. Tomorrow I'll do it. And we realize that the whole month is gone. And how much of the Quran did we read? Sometimes we think it in our minds. When I become 50 years of age, or when my birthday comes along, this is the time I'm going to make the change. This is the time I'm going to start. Lo and behold, whether it be the birthday, whether it be the anniversary, whether it be the month of Ramadan, whether it be the new year, whatever it might be, when the day and the moment arise, you know what we say? Well, I'll start from tomorrow instead. And when that tomorrow reaches, I'll start from tomorrow instead. And we never, never, never start. Let us get a nice battery. And if the battery is not working well, we can go by some fellas and they could give us a nice jump start. We need a jump start in regards to Allah's book. We need to open the Quran. What is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying through his prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she says that the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, indeed, most certainly, for the one who recites the Quran, he recites the Quran beautifully, he recites the Quran precisely, he recites the Quran with such eloquence, that one who recites the Quran and is well versed in the Quran, he will be in the company of the scribes, the angels, the noble angels of Allah. He will be in the company of the righteous ones. But the hadith did not stop there. Glad tidings for all. The hadith continues. And the one who recites the Quran with difficulty, the one who recites the Quran falters in reading, the one who is stammering and reading, the one who is stumbling and reading through the verses of the Quran, for that one, he exerts himself, making an effort to learn, stumbling, stammering, subhanallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, for that person is double the reward as the first person is getting. Who is left out? And still, our hearts are not inclined even to make an effort towards brushing up our Quran, polishing our Quran, making a step to learn to read the Quran. Sometimes we have to wonder, how is it we perform our salat when we can't even read the Quran? Are we praying in English? How do we read or perform our salat? We can't even read the verses of the Quran. How can we move further? How can we learn a surah? Because the Quran is Arabic. There is no shame in learning the Quran. The Quran is the miracle of all miracles. The Quran is the book that elevates. The Quran is the book that takes us higher and higher, a different level. This Quran, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, this is the book. We have to make a sincere effort in reading the Quran now. Now! From today, from this morning, we should have already started with Surah Al-Kahf. Surah Al-Kahf, the protection from the Dajjal. So many virtues, Surah Yasin in the beginning of the day. All our needs will be fulfilled for that day. All. These are the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the most blessed Ashraful Anbiya. And still it is going through one ears and coming through the other ears. So again, the first, fasting on Mondays and Thursdays. Bring it into our lives. Secondly, let us open the Quran today. Today. I'm not saying tomorrow. Today. The best day that the sun rises. Yawmul Jum'ah. The day that Adam was created. Yawmul Jum'ah. The day that Adam came on the earth. Yawmul Jum'ah. The day that Adam alayhi salam passed away. Yawmul Jum'ah. The day that the day of judgment is going to occur. Yawmul Jum'ah. Today is the day that all the creations of Allah, they fear this day which is known as Yawmul Jum'ah. Illa al-insan, except for insan, except for mankind. We take it, it comes, it goes, there's nothing in it for us. No contemplation, no meditation, no reflection. Let's start to read the Quran today. And if we did not know how to learn the Quran, how to read the Quran, Mondays and Tuesdays in the masjid, we have classes. Just give the imam a phone call. I'll be most delighted to help you. To read the Quran, it acts as sadqatul jariyah for us. Anybody who wishes to learn, you don't have to pay anything, it's free. Free to learn the book of Allah. Make an effort to learn the Quran. How many people accept Islam? Comes into the deen of Allah. And there is no effort after that in reading the Holy Quran. We stop right there. I am a Muslim and that is enough. That is not enough. That is not enough. We need to keep progressing in life. In every other aspect of life, we go up the ladder. We start at a very basic wage. But still we keep climbing, climbing because we want our salaries to what? Increase. Nobody wants to stay on the same level all the time. One day you're riding a bike, the next day you have a motorbike, the next day you have a car, the next day you have a van, one day you have a truck, and so you're going. And every time the car and it gets better and better and better. Because nobody wants to stay one place at the same time. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, that one is a sure loser. Who is that one who is a sure loser? The one whose 2 days are equal in accomplishments. Huh? The one whose 2 days are equal in accomplishment, he's a sure loser. These are the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So in preparation for Ramadan, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, those of us who could read the Quran, take the Quran out and start to read from today. Those of us who can't read, come. We would learn to read together. Let us learn to read together. Let the Quran become part and parcel in our lives, of our lives. Do you know that on the day of Qiyamah, this Quran, this fasting, the Quran, the fasting, you know what will happen? These 2 actions that we did, it will stand in front of Allah. It will put up an argument in front of Allah. It will stand and it will debate with Allah in regards to the one who used to stand up, the one who used to open his eyes, the one who used to spend sleepless nights. The salat will say to Allah, the fasting will say to Allah, he left his food, he left his drink, only for your sake, Allah. Only for your sake. He didn't do it for any other reason. not because of starvation, not because of hunger, not because of thirst, not because the imam said he had to do it, not because daddy said he had to do it, not because mommy said she has to do it. No, it is because you Allah said that we have to do it, and we did it. So put up an argument. The Quran will speak. The Quran will debate. Oh Allah, he kept his eyes open. His back was breaking. Her back was breaking. Her eyes remained open during the night, sleepless night, reading and reading and reading your book. No time, oh Allah, no time for any other thing, only for the recitation of your book. Subhanallah. Allah will reward us tremendously for that. Big, big rewards. So one, fasting on Mondays, fasting on Thursdays, and secondly, the recitation of the Quran. One third aspect of preparation is that, of course, when we wake up to fast, we wake up in the wee hours of the morning because we have to take sahri. That standing in the wee hours of the morning, it's very, very important. Nafil salat, whether it be tahajjud, whether it be the nafil after we pray our salat, it can just be optional salat. You can pray optional salat anytime. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Man taqarraba fihi bi qaslatin kana kaman adda faridah fi ma siwa wa man adda faridatan fihi kana kaman adda 70 faridah in the month of Ramadan. Whoever tries drawing nearer to Allah in the month of Ramadan by performing any virtuous deed, any optional deed, any good act, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, then for such a person will be a reward as if he had done a fard act in any other time of the year. A fard, a compulsory act. And if in the month of Ramadan a person performs a fard act, a compulsory act, then it would have been given the reward as though he had done 70 fard. 70. So while we are in this month, let us start to perform the nawafil, the optional prayer. Do optional things, optional acts of virtue, so that when Ramadan comes, it becomes easy. It becomes easy because it becomes part and parcel of our lives. It becomes a habit. It's like a person, the first time he takes a smoke with a cigarette, he might start a cough. But then you know what? You know what he tells himself? I can do better than that. And his partner also tells him that. Laughs at him. Big man like you and you can't smoke a cigarette. And he wants to prove himself. So he takes another pull and another pull until he gets it nice. And guess what happens? As he goes through the walks of life, he becomes so attached to this cancer stick, he can't leave it now. It becomes so sweet in his mouth. Even when he's going to the washroom, he has to take one with him. From the time he finishes eats, he had to take a pull. Whatever it is, he becomes so attached to that. Many other vices we have. This is just a little example. Not pelting stones in anybody's garden. But this is what we are speaking about. When a person could become so attached to that, it is the same manner he can become sweet on doing optional deeds. And making it a habit in his life that when he misses doing that, he becomes restless. He becomes restless. And this is what it means to taste the sweetness of Iman. This is what it means to know that your Iman is growing. That when an opportunity presents itself, you make something a habit in your life. A habit in your life. And now, one morning you wake up late. Or one morning you had to go somewhere else. Every morning you're coming for Fajr in the mosque. Every day you're coming for Zuhar, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. Every day we're performing Salah together in the masjid. And then one day something happened and you had to miss your Salat in Jamaat. It makes you feel empty. Because you have become so accustomed to that. And on the contrary to that, Every day we are missing our salat in Jamaat. We are not performing our salat in the mosque. This is our habit. So now when we come one time in the week, we are feeling like, we're feeling uncomfortable. We're feeling like what people will say about me. You know, like when people see us once a year for Eid, and we have that feeling, what people will say about me, why, once a year. Even I, my own self, saying it, once a year I just go in the mosque. It's not a good feeling. So in other words, let us become accustomed to performing these optional deeds in this month of Shaban. So when Ramadan comes and someone stretches their hands, it will be easy for us to say, hold that. When Ramadan comes and we have to perform our Nafil Salat and our Sunnah Salat and all the different Awabin and Chasht and all these different things, Subhanallah, it will be like nothing. We are already become accustomed to it. It has become part and parcel of our lives. These are just three. Inshallah, there are seven more that we will continue with for the rest of the month of Sha'ban, inshallah. So make sure that you don't miss out on the other seven, because the other seven, they are even nicer and sweeter than these three. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us. May He have mercy upon us. May He help us in this preparation towards the month of Ramadan. La aqlaq at-tadbir, said the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there is nothing more intelligent than preparing. Make sure that you prepare. If you fail to prepare, know very well, prepare to fail. Wal akhir da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alamin.